welcome to St. Bruno and St. Paul's Parish for the Feast of the Annunciation. Our opening hymn can be found at number 584, Come to the Water.
Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Friends, we gather on this day and we celebrate the Annunciation of our Lord, in which the angel Gabriel brings the great news to Mary, the Mother of God, and what she is going to do in salvation history. And so Mary, now more than ever for us people, is a great example of trusting in God, especially in light of these challenges that we face in our country, as well as around the world. Now we turn to Mary and we ask her to pray for us, that we too may have that trust in God, especially during this time in our lives. And so therefore, let us take a moment to prepare ourselves to enter into the sacred mystery, recall our sins, and ask for God's pardon and peace.
To heal the contrite of heart, Kyrie
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who will that your word should take on the reality of human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we, who confess our Redeemer to be God and man, may merit to become partakers, even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Uzziah, saying, "Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld, or high as the sky." But Uzziah answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David, is it not enough for you to weary people? Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you the sign. A virgin will be with child and bear a son and shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please join in singing our psalm response, number 48, "Here I Am."
St. Paul to the Hebrews. "Brothers and sisters, it is impossible that the blood of bulls and goats take away sins. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, 'Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocausts and sin offerings you took no delight.' Then I said, 'As it is written of me in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O God.'" First, he says, the sacrifices and offerings of holocausts and sin offerings you neither desire nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law. Then he says, "Behold, I come to do your will." He takes away the first to establish the second. By his will, we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once and for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I am the light of the world. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
An angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered all sorts of greetings this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will shadow over you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month of her who was called barren. For nothing is impossible with God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to your will." And then the angel departed. The Holy Spirit, the Holy Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, brothers and sisters in Christ, this is a most auspicious day because we hear of this statement that's being made all the way through here. We hear of, "I've come to do your will." And Mary is that perfect example. She is that perfect fiat, that thought that this is the way that we should live our lives. But think about her world and think about her for a moment. This young woman who has been exposed to this opportunity so early in her life, not prepared for it, not assuming anything, yet she sees in this moment the value and the richness of what she is called to do. And therefore she goes and does this. But consider the path that she has taken. This path first starts out with great joy when she gets to meet her cousin Elizabeth. But from that point, her life becomes a very difficult life to live. We see her and her new husband going off to have birth in a very strange area. And then from that point, giving birth in a very simple environment, she is then told to go through her husband off by the Holy Spirit to Egypt, which is not considered a friendly location. And then to be taught again to come back to Nazareth, not her hometown, to live. And of course, we know of our Lord's journey and his ministry, which she follows all the way through the crucifixion and on to Ephesus. But what a journey this is. And what does that speak to us in our lives? Well, certainly, during this moment of time when our lives have asked us to completely change, we must wonder, is it our obedience to see what's going on among us and to be of light in this world, to answer our own fiat, to say, "Lord, this is your will, and I will accept it in my life." Brothers and sisters, these are difficult times, but there's much each of us can do. There is so much we can do for each other, for our neighbors, for our families, and for our friends. We have much to do in our will. And so grasp what it is that you are called to do in this world and be part of the ministry. God bless.
Friends, at this time, let us raise our hearts and our minds in prayer and petition.
For the leaders of the church, may the Lord richly bless them in their ministry and protect them from all evil that surrounds them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our national leaders, that God may grant them compassion and insight in acting for the common good, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and all those who care for them, may God grant them healing, relief, and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our local faith community, may the Holy Spirit continue to empower us in saying yes to what God is asking us to do, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died and have been welcomed into the heavenly kingdom by Mary and the saints into heaven, including today's intentions, Harold Bischel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, we ask you to hear our prayers, and if it is your will, to grant them through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn, number 828, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring you love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, your faith in you. Make me a channel.
That our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Amen. Almighty God, be pleased to accept your church's offering, so that she, who is aware of her beginnings, lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son, may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that Christ was to be born among men, and for men's sake, by the overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit, lovingly she bore him in her immaculate womb, so that the promises to the children of Israel might come about, and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy upon us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her most chaste spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Confidence in the prayer that Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not upon our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, let us offer each other some sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Blessed Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you all. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Sisters and brothers, this celebration is ended. Let us go forth to love and serve the Lord and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great day, everybody, and stay spiritually strong.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 519, Sing to the Mountains.
To the sea. Raise your
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy upon us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her most chaste spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Confidence in the prayer that Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not upon our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, let us offer each other some sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us everlasting life. Amen. Thank you. Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Blessed Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Sisters and brothers, this celebration is ended. Let us go forth to love and serve the Lord and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great day, everybody, and stay spiritually strong.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 519, Sing to the Mountains.
Church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy upon us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her most chaste spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Brew him with him in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Confidence in the prayer that Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not upon our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, let us offer each other some sign of peace.
Mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Blessed Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal joy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Sisters and brothers, this celebration is ended. Let us go forth to love and serve the Lord and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great day, everybody, and stay spiritually strong.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 519, Sing to the Mountains.